हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू एडवांस प्लस एकेडमिक्स। माय नेम इज आलोक पांडे, योर केमिस्ट्री मेंटर। इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द कॉन्सेंट्रेशन टर्म्स। इफ यू रिमेंबर इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर्स व्हाट वी जस्ट डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द सॉल्यूशन डेफिनेशन, टाइप्स ऑफ सॉल्यूशन, देन वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द टर्म कॉन्सेंट्रेशन, द टर्म कॉम्पोनेंट। वी डिस्कस अबाउट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कॉन्सेंट्रेशन टर्म्स, in which we discussed about percentage calculation, parts per million, that means ppm calculation. Then after we started with the concept of mole fraction, but as you know, mole fraction needs mole, and in order to understand mole concept we took 3 or 4 lectures including the assignment where we discussed about the mole concept with respect to mass, that is gram molecular mass, gram atomic mass, as well as amu unit. And we discussed about Avogadro hypothesis, where we discussed about the concept of volume, then we discussed about the Avogadro number, and finally we got cleared with the concept of mole. But now we have to go back to the chapter with the concept of mole fraction. So let's start with the concept of mole fraction, that is our term number 3. What is basically mole fraction? Okay, mole fraction is basically represented by the symbol xi, but sometimes people represent it by symbol x for just simplification or better understanding. Now, what is mole fraction? In order to understand mole fraction, we must have to know about the difference between the ratio and fraction. Let's take an example. Suppose I have an apple. Suppose I take an apple and we have two children. Suppose one is A, another is B, and you have to divide this apple into ratio of 1:2. What will you do basically? Then the ratio is 1:2. If I ask you how many parts of this apple you will do, then I guess you must be doing 3 parts of it, out of which 2 parts of 3 will be given to the child B, while 1 part out of 3 will be given to the child A. Then how did you do that? Actually, you just converted ratio into fraction. Here we see the ratio is 1:2. When you convert ratio into fraction, you just, what you do basically, you take 1, that means for A you take the ratio component of A on numerator, while the sum of the ratios in the denominator, right? In the same way you will do 2 upon 1 plus 2. That means in order to convert ratio into fraction, we have to consider the fundamental, the considerable component in the numerator, while the ratio total is taken in the denominator. In the same way, if I go for the concept of solution, then in a solution we consider that solute and solvent ratio is fixed with respect to its amount, or you can say number of moles. In most of the cases we consider solute as B and solvent as A, right? Then we have to consider the number of moles of solute as well as solvent in a fixed ratio. That means it is supposed that NB and NA are in fixed ratio, right? Now we have to do what? We have to just divide, or we have to convert this ratio into fraction. What we have to do here? We have to consider xi b, that is mole fraction of solute. Mole fraction of solute, and in order to do that, we will consider number of moles of solute in the numerator, while the sum total of NA and NB in the denominator. In the same way, if I have been asked to calculate the mole fraction of solvent, then what we have to do? What will I do here? Mole fraction of solvent will be just equivalent to Na upon me Na plus Nb, right? Then here we can see that xi a and xi b are the mole fraction or respectively with respect to solute and solvent. Now one more thing is that if I add xi a and xi b, then its total will be equal to 1. One more thing, the value of mole fraction is always between 1 and 0. Why? That's it. That is point number 1. Why? If xi is equal to 0, that means, it means particular component doesn't exist, right? Doesn't exist. If xi is equal to 1, it means only this component exists. Point is so important. I guess you are understanding my point. If xi is equal to 0, that means the ratio of that component is not existing in the solution. And when it is 1, that means it is 100%. That means only that particular component is present in the solution. Second point that I have to consider here is, it's not always that we have one solute and one solvent. Sometimes we have ternary solution, sometimes we have quaternary solution, sometimes we have pentanary solution. That's why I have to understand, whatever number, n number of components are present in the solution, just sum total of mole fraction of these components will be equal to 1. Okay, I guess you are understanding my point. Just write it down, then from just note it down, take a pause. After that we will start with the numericals. Later on we will go with the tricks where we will make shortcut formulas, but initially we have to understand the terms and some basic question related to the these terms, or mole fraction, or something like molality, molarity, formality, percentage calculations. Okay, note it down. Okay, I guess you have done that. Let's suppose some examples, some numericals, in order to understand thoroughly the concept of mole fraction. Okay, let's take a question. An aqueous solution contains an aqueous solution contains 20 gram NaOH mixed with, suppose, 80 gram of water. Calculate, first part you have been asked is just W by W percent, that means percentage with respect to mass. Second, mole fraction of NaOH. Now just read the question. It's very, very easy. I can say it is the simplest question in this video lecture. Let's understand what is solute and what is solvent here. Then we are observing that NaOH is being dissolved in water, then H2O must be a solvent. Most of the times water will be considered as a solvent. Water is also considered as a universal solvent due to its higher extent of dissolution. And NaOH is considered as a solute, right? Now, if it is solute, its symbol will be B. If it is solvent, its symbol will be A. Let's start. WB will be equal to 20 gram डब्ल्यू ए विल बी इक्वल टू 80 ग्राम, मोलर मास ऑफ सोल्यूट एन ए ओ एच 23 प्लस 16 प्लस 1 दैट विल बी इक्वल टू 40 ग्राम पर मोल, एम ए दैट इज मोलर मास ऑफ वाटर 2 प्लस 16 दैट विल बी 18 ग्राम पर मोल. नाउ फर्स्ट पार्ट परसेंटेज डब्ल्यू बाय डब्ल्यू, हाउ विल यू सॉल्व दैट परसेंटेज डब्ल्यू बाय डब्ल्यू? दैट विल बी इक्वल टू डब्ल्यू बी अपॉन डब्ल्यू ए प्लस डब्ल्यू बी, राइट? एंड हेयर परसेंटेज डब्ल्यू बाय डब्ल्यू इक्वल टू वट इज डब्ल्यू बी? 20 अपॉन 80 प्लस 20 एंड इट विल बी इक्वल टू 20%. ओके, सेकेंड पार्ट, इन सेकेंड पार्ट यू हैव बीन आस्क्ड फॉर ज़ाइबी, दैट विल बी इक्वल टू ज़ाइबी बिकॉज मोल फ्रैक्शन ऑफ एन ए एच हैज बीन आस्क्ड इन क्वेश्चन एंड एन ए एच हियर इज कंसिडर्ड एज अ सॉल्यूट. दैट मीन्स ज़ाइबी विल बी इक्वल टू एन बी अपॉन एन ए प्लस एन बी. वट इज एन बी हियर? 20 बाय 40. दैट मीन्स आई कैन राइट डब्ल्यू बी अपॉन एम बी. एन ए विल बी इक्वल टू डब्ल्यू ए अपॉन एम ए and WB upon MB. 20 by 40 and WA is 80 by 18 and 20 by 40. Now ZB will be equal to 20 by 40 is 0.5, 80 by 18, 18 4 just 72 and 18 4 just 4. Again 4.4 we can take 4.4 plus 0.5, that will be equal to 0.5 upon may 4.9. you can write 5 by 49, no problem if you write it in fraction. Even I will suggest you that you have to write your answer in the fractions only because you have been asked for the mole fraction, no need to convert into decimal terms. So easy question. Now we will go for the next question and we will use some trick to solve that. The question is, let me consider one easy question again. Question is 28% W by W. 28% W by W aqueous solution of KOH. Aqueous solution of KOH is given. Is given. What you have to do is to just calculate mole fraction of KOH. Now, the point is, you can solve it by the long method and you can use some systematic approach in order to reduce your time of effort. Let's see what you do. Take a pause and just try to solve it. Okay, let me think what we can do here is, you have to calculate mole fraction and mass percentage is given to you, right? Oh, 28%, you can use formula as well, or you can consider let W of solution is 100 gram because percent means out of 100. WB may be 28 because if we are considering solution as 100 gram. WA will be equal to 100 minus 28, that will be I guess 72 gram, and you too. Now we have WB as well as WA here. Now what we have to do is to just solve for mole fraction of KOH. If I go for ZB, that will be equal to NB upon NA plus NB. What is NB? That is the given mass of KOH divided by molar mass. What is molar mass of potassium? 39. What is molar mass of oxygen? 16. What is molar mass of hydrogen? 1. That will be totally equal to 56. And then Na will be equal to 72 by 18 plus 28 by 56. That will be equal to 1 by 2, 28 to 56 upon 4 plus 1 by 2. You can write 0.5 as well. That will be more easier to solve. And it will be equal to ZB will be equal to 0.5 upon may 4.5 and that will be equal to 1 by 9. So easy question. Okay, So what we did here, we just solved with respect to percentage and mole fraction. And in first question, what we did, we were just given the masses and we just converted into percentage by mass as well as mole fraction. Let's solve some one more question where I will apply some different concept. Like, you can solve any question by your concept. Concept building is the better idea, but sometimes your idea doesn't come into application, and that's why you must know how to reduce the effort and how to reduce the time utilized here. Now, question is, an aqueous solution having mole fraction. Of 2/5 mole fraction of 2/5 for glucose. Okay, that means we have aqueous solution of glucose. What is percentage W/W? Calculate percentage W/W of glucose. Let me tell you one thing, with respect to question, we will make some tricks, we will make some short formulas where we will use them directly to solve. It's very, very easy topic, but it utilizes time. It takes too much time, and your burden on the time with respect to paper will be increased. That's why I will suggest you to note down the tricks along with the noting down the questions, right? Now, what we have to do here? You have been given the mole fraction of 2/5 with respect to glucose, and you have to calculate percentage W/W of glucose. Something is like, you have xi b, right? That is 2/5. What is xi a? That must be 1 minus xi b, and it will be equal to 1 minus 2/5. That will be equal to 3/5. If I go for xi a divided by xi b, that will be equal to 3/5 divided by 2/5. It must be equal to 3/2. Okay, xi a by xi b equal to 3/2. Now, xi a by xi b will be equal to na upon na plus nb divided by nb upon na plus nb. This is 3/2 here, and this will be equal to na upon nb. That means mole fraction ratio is equivalent to the ratio of their number of moles. 3/2 equal to wa upon a is water 18, and wb upon glucose, that will be 180. 3/2 will be equal to wa by 18 into 180 divided by wb, that will be cut by 10, and 3/20, right? 3/20 will be equal to wa upon wb. What we understood here is the ratio of mole fraction is equal to ratio of number of moles, and we also discuss how to convert. When we have xi b, we have to calculate xi a. When we have xi a, we have to convert it into xi b. Now, what is the role of it here? Suppose we consider it 1, you have to calculate percentage W/W, that is WB upon WA plus WB, and it will be multiplied by 100. Divide with respect to WB. Agar main isko, if I divide it by WB, it will be equal to W/B/WB, WA/WB plus WB/WB. And into 100, that means it will be equal to 1, WA plus WB is 3/20 plus 1 into 100. Now, I didn't have to convert particularly WA and WB, we have to just use the ratio here, and that will be equal to 23, that will be equal to 20 upon 23 into 100. Rest you will solve by yourself. I think you understood my point. In three questions, what we did, in first question, we have been given the values, we have to directly use that. In second question, we have been given mole fraction and we have to solve, we have been given mass percentage and we have to solve mole fraction. In third question, we have been given mole fraction and we have to calculate percentage mass by mass. So I am thinking that you are getting my points. One more concept we can apply here is, just for the trick you can say, suppose you have to calculate percentage W by W, and that is equal to WB upon WA plus WB, and for percentage you multiply by 100, and you have been given number of moles here. What will you do? That will be equal to NB into molar mass, because you know number of moles is W by M. For calculation of given mass, you have to just multiply number of moles with respect to molar mass. That will be equal to NA into WA, MA, and that will be equal to NB into molar mass of solute. Sometimes we have been given number of moles, then I know you can solve W by individually in this concept also, but it will save your time. What I just converted the given mass is with respect to number of moles and molar masses. I guess you are understanding my point. Next point is mass fraction. Mass fraction is not so much big thing, but sometimes it has been asked in the question, and we discuss about three terms, that is four number. Mass fraction, it is very rarely asked question, but you must know what is formula. It is ratio of, you can say it is fraction of given mass of solute with respect to total mass of solution. That means mass fraction will be equal to WB upon WA plus WB. So easy. Note it down, take a pause, and after that we will go for one question only and we will wind up this topic. Take a pause. Okay, let's start for the next. We have to solve just one question, and that is very, very good question in order to build up your concept. I will repeat, this topic is totally connected with the 11th. You have already discussed about, you have already learned about it in the 11th as well. But as per my concerns, this is more important topic. This is more important topic so that you will build your base for the next concepts like Rawls law, like Henry law, like colligative properties. Okay. Okay. Write the question. An aqueous solution contains NaOH and water in. First part, 3:7 mass ratio. Okay. Second part, 3:7 mole ratio. What you have to do, you have to calculate percentage W by W and mole fraction of NaOH. Let's see what we have to do here. Very, very good question. Take a pause and try at your ends. Then I will go to discuss with you. Okay. First part, A part, 3:7 is mass ratio. Mass ratio means that is WB is 3, then WA is 7, then W of solution will be equal to 3 plus 7. Suppose percentage W by W will be equal to what? WB upon WA plus WB into 100. That will be equal to 3 अपॉन 10 इंटू 100 इजली यू कैन सॉल्व 30% परसेंटेज डब्ल्यू बाई डब्ल्यू. नेक्स्ट वट यू हैव टू डू इज टू सॉल्व विद रिस्पेक्ट टू मोल फ्रैक्शन, राइट. 30% मीन्स 30% डब्ल्यू बाई डब्ल्यू मीन्स सेकेंड पार्ट मीन्स डब्ल्यू बी विल बी इक्वल टू 30 ग्राम. डब्ल्यू ए दैट इज जस्ट रेस्पेक्ट टू द रेशियो ओनली, बट दिस इज नॉट एग्जैक्टली ग्राम मास और एनीथिंग एल्स. लाइक डब्ल्यू ए विल बी इक्वल टू 70 ग्राम. देन जाई बी इक्वल टू एन बी अपॉन एन ए प्लस एन बी. एन बी इज 30 डिवाइडेड बाय यू हैव एन ए इज 40 अपॉन 70 डिवाइडेड बाय 18 प्लस 30 बाय 40. आई थिंक यू विल सॉल्व एट योर एंड्स एंड लेट्स गो फॉर द नेक्स्ट सेकेंड पार्ट बी. सेकेंड पार्ट इज 3:7 मोल रेशियो. 3:7 मोल रेशियो व्हाट इज मीन बाय दैट? दैट मीन्स एन बी अपॉन एन ए इज गिवन टू यू एंड दैट विल बी ऑलवेज इक्वल टू ज़ाई बी अपॉन ज़ाई ए एज यू हैव डिस्कस्ड इन प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन. दैट इज 3:7. नाउ परसेंटेज डब्ल्यू बाय डब्ल्यू. परसेंटेज डब्ल्यू बाय डब्ल्यू हाउ विल यू कैलकुलेट परसेंटेज डब्ल्यू बाय डब्ल्यू? How will you calculate percentage W by W? You know that is xi b WB. What do you know? That is WB upon WA plus WB into 100. If you remember, I can solve it with respect to WB upon 40 and WA upon NA is water. That means 18. So you can say WB upon WA. Let's solve it clearly. WB upon 40 into 18 by WA will be equal to 3:7. If I go for WB by WA, that will be equal to 3 into 40 upon 18 into 7. Or you can say WA upon WB will be equal to 18 into 7 divided by 3 into 40, that is 120. What I have to do here is to just divide by 1 WB, that is WB WA plus WB plus 1 into 100. If you remember that, 1 upon 18 into 7 upon 120 plus 1 into 100. 6 3 ja 18, 6 2 ja 12, 20. That will be equal to 100 upon 20. And 3 7 ja 21, right? 3 7 ja 21 plus 20, that is 41 by 20. It will be equal to percentage W by W is equal to 22,000 upon 41%. Okay, approximately 49 point something must be answer. Let's think, write it 49% approx. What is next? You had been asked for mole fraction as well. Na? How will you solve that? How will you solve that? Xi b. How can you solve xi b? Xi b equal to nb upon na plus nb. If you divide by nb, that is 1 upon na plus nb plus 1. Now na plus nb. Na plus nb will be equal to 7/3. 1 upon 7/3 plus 1, that will be 1. 7/3, 10 into 3, 3/10, right? That will be xi b. I think in this lecture you must understood about the concept of mole fraction, as well as you got through the tricks where you have to do is to just divide the fractions with respect to mole, mole with respect to fractions, mass respected questions or percentage respected questions. If you have been given percentage, you can continue with respect to 100. Okay, the next lecture we will go for the concept of molality, molarity and interrelations of them. Okay, all the best.